The universe is said to have been alive for billions of years, and that would mean that there's a lot of records to be had in that time. But some of them might be more grand than you realize. Join me as I show you 9 of the most extreme records in the universe. Number 9. The largest thing in the observable universe. Hercules, Cornea, Borealis Great Wall. I want you to think about the scale and scope of the universe at large. The universe is a very big place, and to our credit, Earth is able to see a lot of it via very powerful telescopes, probes, and satellites. But even then, we sometimes find something so big, so massive, that it truly boggles our mind. And in terms of what is the biggest thing we've ever seen in the universe, that would be the Hercules Corona Borealis Great Wall. So just how big is the Hercules Corona Borealis Great Wall? 10 billion light years across. No, you didn't hear that wrong. And if you're curious how that compares to the observable universe at large, the known universe is 93 billion light years across, which means that the Hercules Corona Borealis Great Wall is basically 1/10 the size of the known universe. That's huge. But what exactly is it? To keep it basic for you, the wall is a massive collection of gamma ray bursts. These GRBs are very common across the universe, and scientists have actually used them in the past to try and help map the universe at large because of how they move and leave a signature. But even by the scientists who found it back in 2013, they have a hard time figuring out how such a massive structure could exist. Although large superclusters are known in the universe, such as our own 520 million light-year Laniakea supercluster, a supercluster would have to be exceptionally immense to explain the clustering, perhaps 30 to 50 times larger and 200 times the volume of expected typical superclusters. It would be 10 billion light-years away to about 10 to 18 billion light-years across, and would perhaps be even more improbable to form in the universal large-scale structure than the GRB clustering would be on the gamma-ray sky. And you thought the universe was weird before. Number 8. Fastest non-light entity in the universe. Blazar jets and cosmic rays. Let's talk speed for a bit, okay? At present, the fastest thing in the universe is what? This is not a trick question. You honestly should know this. That's right, it's light. Einstein theorized that nothing in the universe should be able to move faster than light, because doing so would break the laws of physics and his ego. And throughout history, we have indeed not found anything that moves as fast as light. But we have found something that moves about 99.9% as fast as light, and it's making a lot of people question what really is possible in the universe. But to be clear, it's not something like a meteor or a shooting star. It's actually balls of gas known as Blazars. More accurately, Blazars are gases that are trapped in material that is ejected from galaxies at literal blazing speeds, which is much faster than anyone ever thought was possible before. This tells us that the typical processes at the cores of these galaxies are extremely energetic and are capable of propelling matter very close to the absolute cosmic speed limit, said Glenn Pinner of Whittier College in Whittier, California. Ponder the power of the fast-moving superheated gas known as plasma. To accelerate a bowling ball to the speed newly measured in these Blazars would require all the energy produced in the world for an entire week, Pinner said. And the blobs of plasma in these jets are at least as massive as a large planet. Scared yet? We're not done. Scientists have also found that certain cosmic rays that are created when galaxies collide are also emitting speeds that are 99.9% the speed of light, but with even more nines at the end of it. It's still not 100% the speed of light, but it's darn close. Many are baffled by how these speeds are even possible, but they're looking into it. And should they be able to push them even farther past that speed, or even go beyond the speed of light? That would cause all sorts of interesting questions. Number 7. The biggest exoplanet in the universe. Denis P. J082303.1-491201b. Without a doubt, one of the most important things that humanity is looking for in the universe is planets, mainly because we're looking for places for us to live one day if we're lucky. But while we are looking for planets that we can live on, we more often than not find planets that are too different from our own to even hope to live on. And that brings us to Denis P. J082303.1-491201b. Yes, that's a long name, and it's a typical one for planets that have no true name and are just among the stars. But this one is special because it's the biggest exoplanet we've ever seen before. Just how big is it? Well, you know our planet Jupiter? Denis P. J082303.1-491201b is 28.5 times the mass of Jupiter. Think about that. Think about how massive Jupiter is, and then think of one that is 28.5 times that. That's a big planet. While we have been able to determine the mass of the planet, we haven't gotten all the other details that we would like about it. For example, we don't know what kind of sun it orbits around, though we do know it takes about 246 days to go around said star. Granted, this isn't a planet we'd remotely want to habitate, especially since it's a gas giant, but it is good to know just how big these planets can get. It helps us with our estimations about the universe at large. Before we continue with these extreme records set amongst the stars, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 6. The largest star in the universe, VY Canis Majoris. Located 3,900 light-years away from Earth, and within the constellation known as Canis Majoris, the Big Dipper for those of you who know astronomy, the star known as VY Canis Majoris is the biggest star in the universe that we know of so far. One of the reasons we know it's a big star is because of its type. It's a red supergiant, also known as a red hypergiant. These are among the biggest types of stars and are so big that they can burn incredibly brightly. In fact, VY Canis Majoris is one of the most brightly lit stars in the Milky Way galaxy, if not the universe itself, depending on who you talk to. So just how big is VY Canis Majoris compared to our Sun? How about 3 billion times bigger? That's right, 3 billion times. If you want to put that into an even scarier context, if you had a ship that could fly around the Sun and go the speed of light, it would take you 6 hours to get to the other side via its circumference. That's a really big star. And if you did that for our Sun, it would be about 14.5 seconds. If you put VY Canis Majoris in our solar system, estimates say that it would be able to reach beyond Jupiter, maybe even reach Saturn. It's hard to say based on what we've seen. This is one star that we should be glad is far away from us, because the light and radiation it would emit would be much more than our planet could handle. Number 5. The smallest star in the universe, OGLE TR-122b. Moving over to the other side of the spectrum, let's talk about the smallest known star in the universe. There are many small stars out there, believe it or not, usually of the red dwarf class of star. But in terms of which one is the actual smallest, that would be OGLE TR-122b. Now, what might immediately surprise you about this star is that while it's small, it's not exactly small in comparison to other things in the universe. For example, OGLE TR-122b is measured in at about 167,000 kilometers, which means that it's actually 20% bigger than Jupiter. So the smallest star in our universe that we know of is still bigger than the biggest planet in our solar system. Our Sun, which is a yellow dwarf for the record, is about 10 times wider than Jupiter. Further putting OGLE TR-122b in context, but what it lacks in size, it makes up for in mass, because while it's only 20% bigger than Jupiter in raw size, in terms of mass, it's over 100 times more. Now, technically speaking, there are more than likely smaller stars than OGLE TR-122b, and that's because scientists have determined the minimum size it would take to make a star via nuclear fusion, and it's smaller than OGLE TR-122b. It's just that we haven't found this kind of star yet. Number 4. Biggest black hole, the Holm 15A black hole. I'm pretty sure we've mentioned this on our channel before, but black holes suck, literally. They are one of the few entities in the entire universe that everyone should fear. They're so powerful they can unravel planets, stars, and so much more. What's even more terrifying, though, is that they can be quite large. And when that happens, whole galaxies are in danger. These are known as supermassive black holes, and there are some in the universe that boggle the mind. In the Milky Way galaxy, there's one known as the M87 supermassive black hole that's 53 million light-years long, yet that pales in comparison to the Holm 15A black hole. Holm 15A is a massive galaxy out in space, and its size towers over the Milky Way and other galaxies, mainly because it's an elliptical galaxy. And that happens when many galaxies collide with one another, which is ironic here because that's how the black hole in question formed. How big is it exactly? We don't really know, but we do know that it has the mass of about 40 billion of our suns. That's a lot of star power. And in fact, that black hole could absorb about 2/3 of all the stars in the Milky Way galaxy. Number 3. Hottest planet in the universe, KELT 9b. KELT 9b is a planet that is well and truly burning the life out of it, and is in fact the hottest exoplanet ever discovered in our universe. Thankfully, this planet is about 950 light-years away from Earth, so humanity won't have to worry about it. But the planet itself is dying in many ways, one of which is that it's tidally locked with the Sun in its system. That means half the planet is always facing the star, making the surface of the planet hot on one side but freezing on the other. The kicker in this situation, though, is that the planet is 3 times the size of Jupiter, and it burns with an intensity of 7,800 degrees Fahrenheit, which is close to what the Earth's core burns at, or what our own star burns at. Because of this heat and its own star's influence, the planet will die as it's burning up the gases that comprise it. Granted, it's going to take a few million years to get to that part, but it's going to get there, and nothing can stop it. Number 2. Coldest planet in the universe, OGLE-2005-BLG-390-LB. Yes, this is yet another planet that has a name that is near infinite. But you'll like its nickname, I promise you. Because while OGLE-2005-BLG-390-LB is the official labeling of the planet, it is known by a much simpler name to NASA, Hoth. Yeah, like from Star Wars. Pretty cool, huh? The reason for that is that it's like the legendary ice planet from The Empire Strikes Back. This planet is cold, like really cold. It is indeed the coldest planet in the known universe. So how cold is OGLE-2005-BLG-390-LB? That is hard to pinpoint. However, based on what we know of the planet from our observations, we can calculate that it's about -370 Fahrenheit, which is freezing cold, and that's saying something. For the record, Hoth was not known to be that cold. Otherwise, the Rebel Alliance wouldn't have gone there as a hiding spot. I'm just saying. What's interesting about this planet, though, is that the size of it is about 5 times larger than Earth. But because of its composition, it's actually very Earth-like, including having a thin atmosphere, which could be a potential boom for the planet. But because of its distance from the Sun and its distance from the Earth, it's hard to know exactly what the surface is like. We honestly don't know if it's a rocky planet or a gas one. Number 1. Oldest planet in the universe, PSR B1620-26b. To wrap this up, let's talk age. No, not the age of the universe, but rather the oldest planet that is said to be within the universe, PSR B1620-26b. This planet is said to be so old that it dates back to apparently 12.7 billion years in total age. That's incredible, as it's believed that the universe isn't too much older than that, give or take a few billion years. Because of this, PSR 1620-26b is known as the Genesis planet, or even called Methuselah after the oldest man ever to live. You almost have to wonder what it would say if it could talk. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of these extremely powerful and weird records set by the universe at large? Can you believe that there are entities out there in space that are capable of such things? Which of these records was the most insane or extreme to you? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.